Oh my god, what have they done? Honey, I can't tell who's who.
Don't shoot me, baby. She's the imposter. Shoot her.
Oh, alright.
Holy shit, what the fuck was that?
What? You said to shoot her.
I know, but like, holy shit. Next time, ask me something only the real me would know. Fuck!
Where's my mic? Hey, Louis fans. Louis Vision here. Power Rangers versus Ultron. Okay, obviously I want the Power Rangers to win. I grew up with the Power Rangers in the 90s and a bit of the early noughties. But you know what? Voltron, I got into Voltron as well. Not the animated series, but the 3D animated series that wound up on Teletoon here in Canada back in the early to mid-noughties. You guys know what I'm talking about?
From days of long ago, from uncharted regions of the universe, comes a legend. The legend of Voltron.
Yeah, I don't know how popular that show was. That's about as much as I know as Voltron. Shit, is that even Voltron, or was that like a ripoff of Voltron? I'm pretty sure it was a spinoff of the same material. I don't know. Anyways, I'm hoping the Megazord wins. Such an epic Zord. Voltron's cool too. Voltron does space battles. Oh shit, could Voltron win? I hope not. Let's find out together. And remember to stay tuned after the reaction. If you have a question for my super ancient magic 8-ball, that is... Yeah, that's a good take. We'll use that take.
So we added some new office amenities that I think will help take the edge off. Like the new office jacuzzi.
Shit, no thanks. You ever smelled a wet sloth before?
Alright, maybe a relaxing massage then.
I got a fair hand.
Alright, how about a nice hot sauna?
They're gonna eat him.
It's a fucking toast oven, Chad.
I'm Mark Slothman, and now I got the sexiest shirt in the market. Death Battle Shirts.
Okay, you are a sloth.
You're gonna find yourself in a sex battle. I don't know what that is, but I know you'll love it, okay?
I was thinking about that. I just honestly just guessed he was a sloth in the last one. I know I'm talking over him, but he's selling t-shirts. Shit, I probably missed a joke. Never mind. I'm sorry, guys. I'll talk less.
It's finally time for one of the biggest matchups in Death Battle.
Did they mention his name? He is Slothman.
Yeah, the giant robot fight of all giant robots.
His first name,
the
Harry.
The Megazord, the heavy-hitting mech commanded by 5 Power Rangers.
I think it is, and I just
Voltron,
got it.
Voltron, the defender of the universe, piloted by 5 Paladins. For this matchup, there will be no Dragon Zords, no Galaxy Garrisons, no Robot Brachiosaurus, and no mice. Just a good old 5v5 war of the giant robots. He's with
Oh
Lambo
man,
stick.
Fuck,
and
that Power Rangers footage
weapons,
is bringing back some serious memories. You guys ever just put on the Power Rangers theme song,
Since the dawn
like
of
after
time,
so many years?
The forces of evil.
Oh my
the
god,
witch,
it's
Rita
fucking
Repulsa
mind-blowing.
And her giant monsters waged war with the good-natured galactic sage Zordon. Their 2,000-year war finally ended when Rita zapped him into a time warp, but not before Zordon managed to lock her up in a space dumpster?
Yes, apparently that thing is a space dumpster. Or
they're superpower galactic beings, okay? Their battles should make a little sense to us mortals.
However, Zordon knew it was only a matter of time before Rita escaped to conquer Earth once more.
Good thing Zordon had thousands of years to come up with a foolproof plan. He could summon the 5 greatest warriors from around the galaxy to defend the planet. Or...
Teleport to us 5 overbearing and over-emotional humans.
No! Not that! Not teenagers!
That plan is asinine. But somehow it worked.
What was his logic
Zordon
there,
granted
anyway?
5 teenagers
people who
were, the
find people passionate about it. I'm literally trying to make sense of it. Passionate
this
about saving the planet. Honestly, the older you get, the more you lose your passion. And I know I'm talking over this guy again. You don't need to tell me anything about the Power Rangers.
Triceratops!
Saber-tooth tiger!
Tyrannosaurus!
Power Rangers!
Go go Power Rangers! First, there's Jason Lee Scott, the Red Ranger. He's a fearless leader, expert martial artist, and owns one of the coolest zords of the bunch.
Power Rangers. You can't expect me to pay attention when you're playing this fucking fire in the background like that.
He loves to work with machines, especially his impressive Triceratops Zord. With its
he was bullied, apparently.
Horns, this 140-ton behemoth can stop a foe in its tracks.
Trini Kwan, the Yellow Ranger, is equal parts brains and martial arts specialist. She's a threat both outside and inside her speedy saber-toothed Tiger Zord.
Kimberly Ann Hart, the Pink Ranger, is a smack-talking valley girl who has the skies covered in her pterodactyl zord.
And even though there were two girl Power Rangers, only the Pink Ranger chose to wear the little skirt.
Last but not least, there's Zack Taylor, the Black Ranger.
See, they were ahead of their time.
Who's mastered his own fighting style called hip-hop keto.
She was okay with the skirt. She likes a little femininity. What am I talking about now?
Yep, this guy fights.
I think
I
started off
dance,
making a good point,
along
and then
with
I
Mastodon Zord.
Strayed.
Although slow, this Zord can freeze blast enemies with ice.
That's not even what really happened either.
Wrap, if you're short on
the Yellow Ranger was originally played by a male,
giant
and that's why you only see the Pink Ranger in a skirt.
Down,
so it's not even something they did on purpose.
Join together to.
We're just the coolest friggin' thing you've ever seen in your life.
I love Power Rangers.
Bring them together.
The Black Ranger's black and the yellow. No.
This is the Megazord.
They're still epic.
33-foot colossus with enough power to effortlessly tear down buildings, sometimes unintentionally. All five Rangers pilot the Megazord
as
one.
Yeah, no one got all up in arms about them doing it.
Giant
Man of Steel, however.
It's like a giant rock'em suck'em robot with laser beams. He can fry enemies with its cranial laser, blast fireballs from its hands.
See, this is the
kind of
shit me and Zack Snyder grew up with.
And even use the Mastodon's face as a shield. And when it's time to send someone to an early grave, they summon their Blade X.
Of course,
Machina,
he's gonna have giant battles where just everything
little known
gets
fact,
destroyed.
Simply touching the power sword can recharge the Megazord if it's low on power.
It's not just a battery.
That was
this
still
giant
pretty
sword
epic.
Is over
no,
100
as long as you don't think about all
and
the death.
The Earth when not in use.
And
plus,
horror
it can launch energy waves and
from
cut down
their perspective,
any monster
like they showed for some
swing
fucking reason.
And there's even more. It's a surprisingly versatile weapon. Like
why am I talking about
they
Man
implemented
of Steel?
Against the Nasty Knight.
Why am I being
any
a dick?
Any energy we throw at him, he just reflects back at us. That's why our weapons are burned out.
So what do we do about it?
Reflect his energy back at him, along with a bit of our own.
I don't get it.
Apparently, the Power Sword can absorb oncoming kinetic energy and turn it against the attacker, drastically increasing the Megazord's striking power.
I get
well,
it.
After
his short,
monsters
his
every
short,
weekday
his
afternoon,
sword is Bishop.
The Power Rangers have been through almost everything, from fighting a world-destroying dragon to
from
a
X-Men
giant walking pumpkin who raps.
The fucking pumpkin. Honest Trailers brought up the pumpkin.
They've even fought Kimberly's purse.
Man, these villains were getting desperate. And so are the Riders.
Anyway, the Megazord is strong enough to lift and throw the 170-ton Dragon Zord into a mountain with little effort.
So long, Gay Bowser!
Even the individual Zords can support the weight of whole monsters on their own. While
see, he can do jokes like that,
similar to the Megazord,
and not seem like a dick.
Even more.
How does he do
in
that?
Fact,
it's because it's like
scale,
he's created
when you
a persona.
The size of an object, its weight increases by a factor of 8. Comparing these organic monsters to human beings means some of them could weigh
you know
as much
mean?
As
I don't even
10,000
I mean.
Tons.
And the Megazord even gut punched one of them over 100 feet into the air.
But even for the Power Rangers, defending the Earth is no small job. When they least expect it, the Megazord's energy supply can be quickly exhausted in the middle of combat.
And it doesn't help that half the reason is because they just get hit.
Creates
so damn
suspense
much
when the story
despite
needs
the Megazord's
it.
Megazord's awesome power, it's really lacking in the whole maneuverability department.
You can make the same
I mean,
arguments
come on,
for the other guys.
At least try to avoid an attack.
But when the enemy hits hard, the Power Rangers hit back even harder. With
why's
the fate
my phone
of the world
vibrating
lying in their hands, no one can ever take them down.
Oh yeah, I turn notifications on YouTube on from my browser. So now anytime anything happens on my YouTube app, I get twice the notifications. I gotta turn notifications off the web browser.
From days
oh, Vulture
of long ago, from uncharted regions of the universe, comes a legend.
In less cryptic terms, 1,200 years ago, the evil Drool Empire nearly conquered the entire known universe. but not everybody was cool with fleets of ships shooting up their planets, so...
Okay, Voltron is the character I know least about, so I'm going to take the opportunity to get, you know, some talking points out now, rather than while Screw Attack is explaining his shit, because I'm going to want to know that. But I think it's fucking cool how they're bringing up Power Rangers and the Megatron, and I'm learning all this shit that I didn't know before. Like, that show was a long time ago, you know? I was just a little kid watching that shit, and it's just like, you know, you watch something you haven't seen in a while, and you notice new things that you didn't understand before. That's what's happening here. And I guess I missed a few episodes because I wasn't even aware of Zordon's origin. Fucking thank you. Okay, all right, let's get back into it.
Through the marriage of magic and technology, they forged a 300-foot-tall living automaton so powerful that it single-handedly pushed back the Empire's onslaught. Before long, the whole universe had heard of the mechanical knight known as Voltron.
Pissed that he was losing everything because of some space robot, the Empire's King Zarkon ordered a space witch to kill Voltron with a magic space spell. And it kind of worked.
Another space
Instead
switch?
Of being destroyed, Voltron was split up into five
which came
very
first,
merchandisable
looks like...
robot lions.
Divided and stripped of its sentience, the universe's best hope had fallen.
Until five space explorers crash-landed on Eris.
I'm guessing
the
Voltron
planet,
came
the lions
first.
Just so happened to be hiding on. Destiny or some crap led them to the castle where the Princess Allura gave them a life-changing opportunity. Pilot the long-lost lions and go around saving the universe for a living.
Keith Cogaine is the head of the Lion Force in more ways than
yeah,
one.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure
As leader
I watched
of the team, he commands his cohorts,
some
and he
sort of American
Black
version
Lion,
of this show.
The literal head of Voltron.
Lance McClane is the Han Solo of the group. This hot-headed show-off controls the Red Lion, which forms Voltron's right arm.
I knocked something
so
over.
Garrett, better known as Hunk, is the muscle
and I
of the
was
team.
A little worried
he
it
pilots
was
the Yellow Lion, which forms Voltron's
the bong, but it wasn't.
Leg.
Oh my
the
god.
The Blue Lion is piloted
sucked.
By Sven Holgersson. No, oh, he did.
There was something empty.
The Blue Lion is piloted by Princess Allura herself, taking over after the original pilot got a bad case
of stabbing.
I was gonna
say, she looks like Princess Peach.
Her lion forms Voltron's right leg.
Last up is Daryl Stoker.
Maybe
you
that
can
was
call
on
him
purpose.
Pitch.
The outfit
Pitch
anyway.
Pilots the Green Lion, Voltron's left arm.
And he's also, well, a little unhinged.
Pitch! Get rid of that grenade!
At least his outfit matches his lion's colors. I mean, damn, it's not that hard, people. Hey, Wiz, you ever think about how the pilots stay in the heads of the lions when they're fighting? That has to be, like, ridiculously nauseating.
Oh, undoubtedly. That's probably why they usually travel by flight and prefer long-range combat over hand-to-hand.
Speaking of which, Voltron got busy fighting Zarkon's giant
I was
giant
about to talk into my coffee.
Hey,
is that a vital weakness?
Voltron
in a hand-to-hand combat situation?
And even pillars of flame out of its hands and feet, or blast the lion heads off like rockets. It can stun enemies with
those
ion dart lasers
weapons.
From its
hey,
head,
is that from the show I was
the
watching?
The
3D animated one?
Chest.
On Keith's command, the Lion Force can manifest Voltron's most powerful weapons out of thin air. Everything from spinning laser blades to javelins.
Teletoon is
a
Canadian network, by the way, for those who don't know.
The real showstopper is the almighty blazing sword.
Marijuana affects the memory.
Which splits Robis apart and also makes a friggin' tornado for good measure.
The blazing sword can also conduct electricity.
Tornado sword,
Voltron
oh shit.
Itself.
Why are all these swords also batteries?
The Blazing Sword is enormously powerful, capable of destroying a satellite hundreds of times larger than Voltron. Voltron himself is powerful enough to melt meteors, kick giant machines sky high, and tank explosions the size of countries.
Scratching
the
my leg with the microphone
lions
right
have
there.
Even traveled between galaxies
I don't think
in less
you would
than a
hear
day,
that.
Making them several times faster than the speed of light.
Voltron has also survived landing on the Omega Comet, which is so dense it possesses the gravitational force of a black hole.
Okay, that all sounds insane, but even giant robot man lions have their limits. Like getting banged up on by multiple Robis at once.
If it's so dense it has the density of a black hole, wouldn't that make
but
it a black hole?
Black hole levels of gravity? That's a cakewalk, right?
Voltron may be strong, but it lacks the finesse and skill of one trained in martial arts. Voltron also carries a shocking design flaw. If the release plates on its joints are struck in combat, it could jettison an entire limb from the core body.
Wait. You're telling me that if I kick Voltron, freaking Voltron, in the shins hard enough, he'll just lose a leg, it'll just pop right off?
Essentially, yes, though it has only happened in training. Even so, whether the
still
line
the black hole thing that's
issue
fucking
or a colossal
strong
Robeast, the universe can always depend on Voltron.
Defender
all
of
right,
the universe
the
versus
Let's end
oh
this
my
debate
god, I really want the Power Rangers.
Oh, this talk of robots
make
is making
win,
me
then
hungry. So let's fix
look
that.
Look how badass it looks.
Now, I'm a man who likes a good home-cooked meal, but going out to buy or hunt my own food is a hassle. If only there was some way food could be brought straight to me.
Good news, Boomstick. Introducing Blue Apron, the number one fresh food delivery service in the country. Using only the freshest ingredients,
Blue
Apron delivers a kit of
any pizza
meals
place
straight to your door, along with easy-to-follow instructions.
A restaurant that
plus
delivers.
Plus, the ingredients are perfectly proportioned, so it cuts down on waste, and you know you're using
I'm
the
kidding
right amount. On top of that,
eating
you can log into their website and select the upcoming meals that sound good to you, like the
I'm
spinach fresh mozzarella pizza with olives.
Plus, it does feel rewarding cooking new and exciting meals right in your own home. But don't just take our word for it. We want you to try it.
Because you're watching Death Battle, you can get 3 meals free with free shipping by heading to blueapron.com/battle.
Seriously, you will love how good it feels and tastes to create incredible home-cooked meals with...
Scanners on, team. Seems the prehistoric activity originates here.
Finally,
if
the
I
animation
don't see a dinosaur today, I'm blaming
some
you.
Effort in. No, they put effort in
I'm
every
picking
time
up something.
And I actually do like the 2-bit, the 8-bit, 2D style, whatever you want to call it.
Hello.
I like that style. And it suits the battle sometimes.
Now.
But in this instance, I like it going this direction. This, I'm fucking psyched. This looks
think
epic.
I found the dinosaurs.
All right, Rangers, log on!
Zack here, this is Kick.
Oh,
this is Billy, all systems
this
go.
This actually does look
Treating
awesome.
Recording, ready to rock. I love this part. Let's tame these kittens.
Scratching my leg again. You can't hear that.
For Voltron!
Power Rangers and all this cool shit. Meanwhile,
and
go Voltron!
Form, arms, and body.
Matt Damon.
And
I'm kidding, Voltron. Both look pretty badass. I grew up with the shit on the left, but the shit on the right. Oh, I didn't even realize there was that much of a size comparison. You guys did your research. Still, black hole withstanding capabilities.
Form spinning laser blades.
Those weapons, man. Oh, the sword! I remember the sword! Oh shit! See, I'm pretty sure it's fully armed now. The Megazord's fully armed. You can't. Where can he go from there?
Seriously! Form Blazing Sword!
Shit, here we go. Show him what you got. Oh, yes!
Wait, the sword!
Oh, come on! I love that. It's like Star Trek.
him up.
Maybe I should be quiet.
Oh!
All right, guys, let's finish this.
We need to move.
Get away!
Come on! His arm is off. No!
Give him covering fire!
With what?
Everything!
Oh, shit, Star Trek style again, but reboot.
Fire everything!
Wait,
oh, fuck!
It's too much!
Oh fuck, did they destroy the Mastodon shield? No!
KO!
Now that's what I call a battle!
God damn it, you better explain yourselves, Screw Attack.
While the Megazord boasted excellent abilities in hand-to-hand and sword combat, Voltron couldn't go down so easily.
Voltron's huge arsenal put it ahead, especially in long range. Even when the Megazord could get in close, it couldn't keep up with Voltron's blazing speed. I mean, Voltron travels between galaxies in a matter of hours, and it can fly.
The Megazord once punched a monster weighing at most 10,000 tons, 133 feet into the air. In contrast, Voltron kicked a 3,900-ton mutated bulldozer.
Yeah, I get it. It's black hole strong, dude. That's kind of infinite.
This is still
in terms of the laws of
feat.
Physics.
Comparing weight and distance traveled for both feats, Voltron's requires at least 5.5 times more strength.
Plus, Voltron clearly had the superior durability, especially with that black hole comet feat.
The Omega Comet's pull could destroy entire planets within 62 miles of itself, which means the comet could output forces of over 13.6 billion newtons.
The Megazord couldn't survive anything close to that level of power. We can prove it. Later in Power Rangers history, they upgraded their mech to the Thunder Megazord, which is specifically stated to be more powerful than the original Megazord in every way.
When this new Megazord fought against a giant Zord called Serpentera, which at full power
could destroy planets, I remember that.
A single blast from it easily tore the Thunder Megazord apart. And that blast didn't even use half of Serpentera's power.
Voltron outclassed the Megazord in almost every way that counted, including strength, speed, and durability. Trust me, I'm not lying.
The winner is Voltron.
Because it's made of lions.
Don't go away, we're about to reveal who's fighting in the next episode. And if you want to see behind the scenes commentary on this episode, then just click that box and start a 30-day free trial for a first membership. Thanks, guys.
Who's next? All right. I don't know who any of those people are. No, I'm kidding. I think I recognize at least one of them. I'm gonna do my research before the next death battle. It's happening May 3rd, so. All right. We're going to be right back after a quick commercial break. Maybe. You know, YouTube. Well, I gotta say, I was on the edge of my seat for that one. I was rooting for the underdog, I guess. And you know what? Stan Lee once said, I forget his quote, so I'm gonna have to paraphrase him, but someone was mentioning, you know, he was talking about, you know, who would win in a fight between heroes. Honestly, in any situation, it's up to the writer. It all depends on what the writer wants. And you know what? There's a reason why Batman will often win against Superman. There's a reason why Iron Man can beat the Hulk. People love rooting for the underdogs. And I think the fact that, you know, the Zordon was still able to defeat these enemies, despite these enemies being able to inflict such damage to their Zord in a single blow, just shows how creative they're able to use their abilities. Creatively. I really wanted them to win. No, don't be salty. Fuck. Voltron's still cool. And it just... Voltron was the logical choice. I can traveling across galaxies, withstand black hole shit, and black hole shit, and fucking all this other stuff. Galactic type shit. Megatron. The Megazord's pretty Earth-based, but is still pretty badass. And no, man. No, I liked it. I liked it. Good on ya. Can't wait for the next one. I saw something about Dr. Manhattan versus Genie. I don't know if you guys would ever actually do that, but that would be fucking epic. Shit, because they both kind of... That's a good question, because Genie, even though he's all-powerful, he is a genie, and he's kind of, like, bound by laws, isn't he? Dr. Manhattan is, too. Genie, he can't make people fall in love, and Dr. Manhattan, he can't, he can change almost anything, but he can't change human nature. They're actually quite similar. All right, everybody got your questions ready? Here we go. It is certain. What does that one say on the other side? Oh, never mind. It is certain. For another time. If you like this, you'll probably also get a kick out of this shit right here, right there. That is some good shit as well. I'm Louis Vision.